as Donald Trump.
And it hurts your feelings? That is not our problem, brothers and sisters. You need to uncouple yourself in that way and just go on with your life and understand that he is going to be subject to criticism that is not pointed at you personally. You should stop taking it personally.
If anybody said some of the things that Donald Trump said, we would talk about it. Yes, so we talk about it when Donald Trump says it. But we don't talk about Donald Trump as much as we could. And remember, if you're that sensitive to any comments about Donald Trump, you're a snowflake. Do you really want to go through life as a snowflake? All right, we gotta get to a break soon here.
I'll leave you with this one. This text just says, I would rather listen about you swimming in the lake, LOL.
Well, exactly. But think about how much attention is paid to talking about, like, Taylor Swift, or when we talk about, just fun, ridiculous things. And this show, from 1 to 4, is not dedicated to politics. We talk about politics, and we got to talk about a horrible shooting. We got to talk about some of this stuff, but we're not dedicated to it. We talk about everything, and really, the show is billed as where politics and pop culture meet your opinions. So there's a lot going on here that has nothing to do with politics. All right, if you want to join us, the Open Our Jewelers Talking Text Line, 504-260-1870. 39 years ago today, it was on this day, February 15th, 1985, The Breakfast Club was released to movie theaters across the country. Directed by John Hughes, it was critically acclaimed and is consistently ranked as one of the greatest. Here's how you can check out. saying. It totally took over the conversation about celebrating goodness in America. If you've got a comment, the Open Heart Jewelers talk and text line is 504-260-1870. Let's go to Derek and Gonzalez. Hey, Derek.
Hey, Scoop, my man. It's been a long time, bro, since I talked to you.
I appreciate you calling, Derek.
Hey, I just wanted to say, I mean, as a guy that, you know, grew up in New Orleans, that grew up in the projects of New Orleans, never had the thug mentality, always wanted to be better. You know, I work in hospitality. You know, we had to shoot right in the same block of my hotel.
Royal and Canal.
I was sitting there hearing people staying in my hotel talking about how much they, you know, that they will never come back to New Orleans because New Orleans is not what they expected. And it's so different in the mentality of the people and the thugs that hang on Canal Street. It's like you said, it's group unprotected sex, and they need to bring the Wrap It Up campaign back. Because you're having these girls, having these babies, 4 and 5, with no father figure, no structure in the family. So how are you going to be successful if you have no structure? It's just sad, man. New Orleans used to be extraordinary. Used to be great, man. I'm just waiting my time till I retire, man. I got 5 years left. I'll be done.
Well, Derek, you take care of yourself. I'm sorry that you feel that way, but I understand that you feel that way. And yeah, a shooting. I mean, Royal and Canal is a prime location in downtown New Orleans. Second most prime location to Royal and to Canal and Bourbon. Royal and Bourbon, and a shooting there. And so you're hearing from a valet who works at a downtown hotel right near where that happened. And people are saying they're never coming back. This needs to be dealt with. And the people who represent our city, the people who sell our city, they know this. But the city has to do something. And by the way, Mayor Cantrell is in California at a mayor's meeting. Okay, that's fine. But Mayor, come back and tell us what you learned. Come back and tell us how you spent our money to the benefit of us, our city. And maybe there should be pressure on the mayor, as the leader of our city, to encourage more people to speak up about the learned behavior of thug mentality. And don't bomb me with lack of jobs, because there are jobs out there. And I see so many people in jobs. And I so respect them for doing the right thing. But there's just too much of this. And what happened in Kansas City is a result of what we see. Of what we see here. And it just seems like there is this idea of ruining the celebration of goodness in America. With a shooting. It's self-protection. Remember the Mother's Day? Remember the Mother's Day second line in New Orleans? There was some 12-year-old girl's birthday in New Orleans. And these celebrations of goodness, they just are marred by this thug mentality. The idea that everybody's got a gun. The idea that you have to have a gun to be somebody. And boy, if I get an argument with you, I'm pulling up a gun. That doesn't make you a man. That's not the definition of a man. And unless that is taught to young males, nothing is going to change.
time and coordinates the care you deserve. To schedule your appointment or find your nearest location, visit primarycareplus.com.
Now, your Garcia Roofing forecast on WWL.
Well, we're getting ready for the weekend here, and the weather is not going to be pretty, but it'll be a nice weekend to take it easy and maybe stay inside and recover from Mardi Gras. Today's high is 69 with some clouds. Tomorrow,